library. Now, all of that said, let us have a moment of silence as we prepare to worship God in this space.
Thank you. from Amos. Hear this, you that trample on the needy, and bring to ruin the poor of the land, saying, when will the new moon be over so that we may sell grain? And the Sabbath, so that we may offer wheat for sale? We will make the ephah small and the shekel great, and practice deceit with false balances, buying the poor for silver and the needy for a pair of sandals, and selling the sweepings of the wheat. The Lord has sworn by the pride of Jacob, surely I will never forget any of their deeds. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taken from the book of 1 Timothy. First of all, I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings be made for everyone, for kings and all who are in high position, so that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and dignity. This is right and is acceptable in the sight of God our Savior, who desires everyone to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God, there is also one mediator between God and humankind, Christ Jesus, himself human, who gave himself a ransom for all. This was attested at the right time. For this I was appointed a herald and an apostle. I am telling the truth, I am not lying, a teacher of the Gentiles in faith and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. gospel of our Savior Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said to his disciples, there was a rich man who had a manager, and charges were brought to him that this man was squandering his property. So he summoned him and said to him, what is this I hear about you? Give me an accounting of your management, because you cannot be my manager any longer. Then the manager said to himself, what will I do now that my master is taking the position away from me? I am not strong enough to dig, and I'm ashamed to beg. I have decided what to do so that when I dismiss his manager, people may welcome me into their homes. So summoning his master's debtors one by one, he asked the first, how much do you owe my master? He answered, 100 jugs of olive oil. He said to him, take your bill, sit down quickly, and make it 50. Then he asked another, how much do you owe? He replied, 100 containers of wheat. He said to him, take your bill and make it 80. And his master commended the dishonest manager because he had acted shrewdly. For the children of this age are more shrewd in dealing with their own generation than are the children of light. And I tell you, make friends for yourselves by means of dishonest wealth, so that when it is gone, they may welcome you into the eternal home. Whoever is faithful in a very little is faithful also in much. And whoever is dishonest in a very little is dishonest also in much. If then you have not fulfilled with the dishonest wealth, who will entrust you to the true riches? And if you have not been faithful with what belongs to another, who will give you what is your own? No slave can serve two masters, for a slave will either hate the one and love the other, or be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and love. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Thank you.
and sees. His hat. And in his hat, three baby crows. Harold tucks the crows in tight, then quietly climbs down from the nest. Even without my woolly hat, he whispers, I am still a very special bear. A helpful bear named Harold. The good news is not about deserving. The good news is not about equity. The good news is not even about justice, not as we understand it. The gospel, the good news, is about the forgiven debt. It is about the forgiven sin. It is about the forgiven trespasses. As we forgive those who trespass against us, as we forgive those, this is about radical forgiveness in every sense of the word. And in this, we have a forgiveness that afflicts the comfortable, a forgiveness that comforts the afflicted. It was a comfortable hat, and it kept the babies warm. They knew the terms of the debt. They willingly signed on the dotted line. And if we forgive them that debt, where will it end? I mean, you can't just go and forgive everyone their trespasses. That would be irresponsible. That would lead to chaos. I mean, they knew what they were getting into. A sign was posted. And clear as day, no trespassing. But beyond the sign is a path. Beyond the sign is a path that the lost sheep took. Beyond the sign is the place that the lost child has gone. And we have a choice. Do we forgive them their trespasses and go in search? Or do we simply shake our heads? The fence was in disrepair. The farmer should have kept better watch. The child should have known better. Where were her parents? We have a choice. Do we stop at the posted sign? Do we forgive those who take what they are so desperately in need of? Do we forgive as God forgives? We have a choice. Do we stop at the posted sign? Or do we find the lost, heal the brokenhearted, forgive each other our debts, our sins, and our trespasses? Forgive each other using God. our own lives. And the words from our tradition which we speak each week. Consider the choice. Because in a nest somewhere, there is a mother who has not asked for permission and is counting on forgiveness instead. Amen.
Pray for the church, for the world, and for our own needs and concerns.
Save the afflicted among us.
Have mercy on the lowly.
Raise up the fallen.
Appear to the needy.
Heal the brokenhearted.
Restore the mourners of thy people.
Feed the hungry. Up the sick.
Comfort the faint-hearted.
In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for Igreja Episcopal Anglicana do Brasil, the dioceses of Mpumalanga and Itata in the Anglican Church of Southern Africa, the diocese of Mpwa in the Anglican Church of Tanzania, the Diocese of Muhabura and Bukono in the Church of the Province of Uganda, and the Diocese of Multan in the United Church of Pakistan. In our diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for Episcopal Homes of Minnesota, Episcopal Group Homes, Guardian Angels, and all other institutions that do ministry for and with the elderly. We also pray for the St. Matthew's parishes in St. Paul and Chatfield. And we pray for all those we lift up at this time, either silently or aloud.
For Chris and Heller as they prepare for their wedding here next Saturday.
For the children of Ukraine.
I give thanks for formation in our community and the ways in which we are all growing into the full stature of Christ. And today I give thanks for mentors, teachers, and friends. Pray for babies Judy and Audrey.
prosper as they continue to adjust to being human, and their parents.
Pray for the immigrants who are being bused from Texas to various parts of the United States, and we give thanks for those communities who are receiving them and helping them to find a place to shelter.
For St. Andrew's Episcopal Church on Martha's Vineyard, and the leadership and compassion they have shown in this effort.
We give thanks for this community. We give thanks for the coming of fall.
Are there others? Haste, O God, the coming of your kingdom. And grant that we, your servants who now live by faith, may with joy behold your Son at his coming in glorious majesty, even Jesus Christ, our only mediator and advocate. Amen.
Let us pray
for the church, for the world, and, let us confess our sins to God. Most merciful God,
we confess our sins against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have not done. We have not loved you with our whole hearts. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may live by life in your will and walk in your ways.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. May the peace of Christ be always with you. We share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took a cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. In newness.